Today's tutorial is on using JAWS screen reader with Microsoft Excel. If you are a disability support specialist, you may be called upon to train blind or visually impaired students on how to use JAWS with Excel. Lesson 4, Data Entry and Formatting. Okay, we're going to go through some of the simple things to format content. I'm going to go down here to Sales. And we're going to format this cell using the home ribbon. I'm going to press Alt-H. And then if I want to go to the font, I can press FF.
Lower.
And type in a font name. So I'm going to type in TI. And that gives me Times Roman. And then I'm going to press Tab.
Font size edit combo collapsed 11 to 4.
And I change that to 14. Another thing I could do is I could press Tab.
Tab, increase font size button to move through the controls.
And press Spacebar.
Space, leaving menu bar, Sales, A2.
And you see that it took me down to the word Sales, where it's now 16 point. And so those are your basic formatting things that you can do. You can also add boldface, italics, underline. Of course, if I wanted this bold, I would just do Control B.
Bold on.
And for italics, Control I.
Italic on.
And Control U for underline.
Underline on.
Now I'm going to undo that by pressing Control Z.
Undo.
Now, if you have a
category,
a bit of content in your table, what you can do is you can hold down the Shift key and press right arrow.
Select 28. Increase or decrease.
That's the extent to the width of the table. So if I press Shift key and go down arrow.
Select A1, category D12, blank.
And so I'm in D12, but I know that I had typed something in A12. And the columns B, C, and D are going to be the number content for those cells. So what I want to do is show you how to just format this table with a very simple command. So you're going to press Alt-H.
Alt-H, ribbon.
And then you see over here,
tab, to change ribbon, use left or right arrow.
You see it says format as table, so I'm going to press T.
T, leaving menu bar, ribbon, lower ribbon.
And I'm in the light section. I'm just going to move over to where it's green. I'm going to press right arrow.
Light blue, light orange, white, light yellow, light blue, light green, table style.
Then I press enter.
Enter. Upper ribbon, group box, home tab, to change ribbon, use left or right.
Now, in this case, it allows me to type in the data that I want. And you see that it starts off with an equal sign, and then a dollar sign, then the A column, then a dollar sign, then the I row with a colon, which means throughout. So from A1 through D12, it's going to mark that up. And I already have a tick that says my table has headers, and that's going to allow me to format the table so that those bits of content at the top will be column headings. So I'm going to press enter.
Enter. Sample workbook, selected range, A1, category, D12, blank.
Now I've noticed that there is a conflict between JAWS and Excel. So if I press the control key to shut up JAWS, it will actually go to this screen.
Tab, formatting tab, to switch pages, press control tab.
And so there's a conflict there, so that's why I'm letting JAWS speak more. Now, I do have some more things that I want to show you in this formatting area, but right now, all I'm going to do is pause the video so I can move on to something next, which is to deal with the column width, which is very important for your blind students to know how to handle that because they can't see that. And as you see where it says in A3 less sales return and allowances, it's going all the way across into D. So we need that first column to be all selected, and then we need to fix the formatting so that it auto fits.
Pause. Please wait. Sample workbook.
Again, I told you that you need to press Control Home to get to the A1 cell.
First cell.
And what I want to do is I want to hold down shift key and then select down to A12. So I'm going to hold down shift and then press down arrow.
Select total A12.
And I want this to format. So the way to do that is to press the Alt H key.
Alt H. Upper ribbon group.
O for format.
O. Lower ribbon cells group.
And then it says Autofit row height for A and Autofit column width with I. So I just press I.
I. Leaving menus. Selected.
That is how you're going to be able to have the content within the column fit within that column so that it's easy to read and understandable. Now I'm going to populate the rest of the content into the table. All right, we're at cell A1, and what we're going to do is come over to the B column,
2019 B1.
Move into the actual data,
1,120.
And what I'm going to do is I'm going to press shift and go down.
Select one.
Now what I want to do is I want to go up to the home ribbon. So I press the keystroke to get to the upper ribbon.
Upper ribbon, group box, home tab.
And then I need to move to the word general here in the middle above number. And that is the N key for number.
And lower ribbon, general, home, group box, number.
Then I'm going to go down through this list.
General, number. Currency.
And press enter.
Enter, leaving menu bar, selected range, B2.
Now I'm going to move over, and then I'm going to press the shift key.
Select.
Do the same thing. I'm going to press Control H.
Alt H.
And
upper ribbon, lower ribbon, general, land, gen, number, currency.
I could also use accounting. Currency or accounting would work in either of these cases. So I'm just going to select currency again.
Enter, leaving menu bar, selected range, C2, $1,009,000.
Another issue that your students might need to know in the number situation is press Alt H. And then
upper ribbon, group box, home tab, to change ribbons, use left or right arrows to navigate.
They would have to memorize some of this. So what I'm going to do is move the decimal point away from the cents. So I'm going to press 9.
9, leaving menu bar, selected range,
C2, that again.
Alt H. Upper ribbon 9, leaving menu bar, select.
And I'm going to select this column and remove the cents again.
1,074,006, Alt H. 9, leaving menu bar, Alt H. 9, leaving menu bar, selected range, B2.
Now we have both of our columns set the way we want it to be. That is the basic knowledge that someone will have to know when working with basic Excel spreadsheets.